How's it going? So, I'm gonna do a quick little video. I'm gonna do a video of some testing. We're gonna do some testing. Right now I have gone through my wires set up again. I got rid of this TV. Steve was nice enough to donate this nice little mini Trinitron to me. So that's working out. It's a space saver for me. It's got these cool built-in speakers on there. It's got some pretty cool options to the TV. Just for like tweaking brightness and stuff. And you can't really see any of that. But it's nice and easy to switch to the video mode to get this. So I can be able to take a picture of what's going on with the screen for the listing. But I'm pushing right along. I got some more stuff listed. Got a ton of stuff listed. Maybe another 50 items. And then I got some sheets already made for that pile right there, starting of the paper lot. Just kind of doing a little feel out of what's going on, what's going to happen with that. I had a little problem hooking up these receivers for some weird reason. Every time I hooked up the left and rights, it got flip-flop somehow. I don't know how, but it would. I don't know how. It took me over an hour to get it running. Basically, the red kept running as the white, and the white kept running as the red. Turn down the radio a little. And then, so that wasn't really working out. It took me, you had to switch out the receiver. There's the other receiver. I did retest that. That does work. And I already got through one CD player that didn't work, but it had a remote and a manual for it, so we'll try to get some money out of that. Which it's a good one. It was a Yamaha. So I don't know, maybe I can get rid of it for like $10 at the flea market as a broken unit. People like to fix stuff, pull electronics out and try to dive in and fix something themselves. This one I tested, that checked out, and we listed this TIAC, the RWCD22. It's a CDR recorder, so you can kind of like, it's kind of like a burner, so you can burn your own CDs, make copies and stuff like that. It only burns CDs, no DVDs. Right now we're working on this DVD DMR. We're gonna get that listed. So I got all cleaned up. Took me like 20 minutes to a half hour to clean this puppy up. I buffed out some of these scratches. I could work at it more with some like light water and a real light sandpaper. I could buff that out if I really wanted to, but I think that'll be all right. And then this remote is pretty shot, but it works. And it took me about 15 minutes to clean the head tape all over it. About 15 minutes to clean the tape off. It's not perfect or anything. Far from perfect. Took Gooby Gone to it. I took detergent to it. I could take some, maybe some alcohol to it. Some peroxide. I don't know. I don't want to burn the plastic. So I might just leave that. I got that listed at 180. Yeah, kind of stretching it, but so I'll show you. Go into this back room and see what we're working with here. Let's see what we're gonna try and get done. So So I need to go through all these units. I think I'm just going to retest everything for the sake of retesting, and then label everything that's tested, shrink wrap everything that works, leave everything that's not working unshrink wrapped, and move that back over here, all the broken ones, for the flea market, and then just try to process some of these units. It'll be a lengthy process, so I'm gonna start to unwrap them, and if I gotta do a time lapse for it, then that's what we'll do. All right, so here we go. I'm coming back in. All right, till I get back.
Okay, you got that one listed. Cleaned it up, listed it. Just gonna get it ready for shipping.
Selling a $200 recorder, you want to
pack it well soon. Trying to hold some decent protection on this thing here. We'll still put bubble wrap around everything, but just want to hold a little protection. Basically, this is getting my item tighter for the box. Last one, I get it real tight. That's it. Bubble wrap once around, maybe twice on this one. You gauge it, you know, if it's 100 and under, you use a good layer of thick bubble and maybe some padding. You're good to use styrofoam on the bottom and top and then wrap it with bubble. Like a nice thin layer of like half inch, cut it to size. So the good thing about that is I've been, where are they? Right here. I'm saving some of these CDRs. This isn't a really a good writable disc for yeah, this isn't what I want, but I'm gonna go look for them. They're somewhere around here, and once I find them, I'll toss one in there. Basically, it's a CDR. That's a CDR too, but I don't know if I can use this in a player. I don't think this is for DVD. RW drives. I could toss this in there just to toss it in there until I find the other discs, but yeah, we'll include that. Bada bing. Shop. Forehead. Hi-fi. Here we go. And your channel 2, yeah? Supposed to be a video? It's supposed to be a channel. Channel 2. I'm going to back here. Channel 4. Oh, these channels don't work too well. Channel 4. Alright, coming back at you. We'll figure this one out here. Let's try to pop in a thing. Let's see what it does. Get some old, Elvis. Elvis. Broadcasting methods. Hopefully this doesn't eat that. That don't sound good. Let's see if I can eject it. Well, I got it back at least. I gotta stop using nice VHSs to test. Alright, going in here. Let's grab a shitter. Uh.
don't sound healthy. We get some play. Back at you. All right, we figured it out. Chop forehead tested, working, clipping. Let's check the clippage here. I'm gonna shimmy the wires around a little, tap on it. This gives it the old durability test. That puppy's not. This is pretty good unit. Yeah, I think I got the remote in one of these totes. We'll dig that out. We'll wrap this puppy up. All right, we got this Audio Technics we're trying to get working here, and just going through and checking all the disc drives. Got to check each disc drive. Got 2 and 3 left. There's 2. There's 3. Okay, 2 and 3 left here. Actually a pretty good CD player. Okay, and we got 3. It's good. I'm gonna get back here. There we go. All right. Sorry for this angle. It's like, holy shit, what am I watching? Close. I'm just gonna up close and personal test job here. All right. Audio Technics compact disc player 5 changer SLPD9 tested, working, ready to go. Clean her up and we're gonna list it up, and then we're gonna clean it up, comp it out, see what it's supposed to do, and then list it up, pack it up, put it in storage. Here we go. All right, we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 done. It took about 2 hours. Clean, test, list. What's that? 2 hours, 5 units. You're about 20, 25 minutes each. 20, 25. So I got to go ship out 4 items. Over here in the bag, ready to go. Got boxes in the car, and then hopefully this guy's gonna call me about the unit. So picked up a unit, paid $250 for it. It was 2 weeks ago. Cleaned it out in a day, and donated about half of the unit. So I stored maybe the other half and donated the other half. Didn't really throw anything away, just mainly donated it.
So the guy made contact with the storage unit company and he wants to buy his unit back. You know, I told the storage company the logistics of the unit, that it's already been processed and half the stuff's gone, and if he wanted the other half, I'd be willing to, you know, work something out with him. I haven't made any money on that unit yet, so technically out $300. But it's mainly he wants his clothes back and his DVDs. So we didn't know what to do with the DVDs. We donated half of them, so he's not going to get all of them back. He's only going to be able to get one box back, and probably more than half of his clothes and some of his shoes, and the rest, it's already been processed, and I wish I would help him, but you know, I took the risk of buying the unit. I cleaned the unit out. It cost me $50 to throw away some of the trash, which was some of his stuff. I say I didn't throw away anything, but it was like, you know, kitchen utensils, which was pretty much junk, and his mattress. So I don't know what to say. Trying to be a nice guy and you know, work it out with him. I wish he called me yesterday. It would have just been a whole lot easier for me and him, and I would have baked him a cake and brought him a cake, because basically he was in Africa and he couldn't pay his unit. He left the obligation to somebody else and they didn't do it for him, so his stuff, when he came back, his stuff was gone. So that's tough. So we're willing to negotiate with him and try to get him his stuff back, and I'd like to get that done today. So I'm going to make a phone call to the storage company and just see if they talk to him and see what he wants to do. Other than that, we're off to ship some items and be back to test some more stuff, and then on our way to Lowell for tomorrow's big pick estate sale. It's a gargantuan, very massive. The words they used was ridiculous. So it's a ridiculous estate sale. And the guy was a collector of like everything. Pretty cool. So it should be a pretty cool sale. There's going to be a bunch of lots, and just some really good fresh pickings and stuff that's probably dating back to the 1800s for sure, because some of the pictures were just like, this guy was just a immense collector of mainly antiques, 20s, 30s, 40s, 50s, a lot of items like that in that era, and I'm sure there's more in the 1800s, maybe 1880, 1890. It's pretty common to find some stuff like that, so that'll be a good pick. We won't bring a full budget, but we will definitely bring at least $500 to, you know, make a good enough pile to have a little bargaining chip where I got some money and could just make a big pile and hope for the best. Yeah, hopefully I bring my A game. It's all about the A game. You stay focused, look at the pitches, do the research, keep your mental notes, keep your eBay mental notes on your mind, and about, you know, just your picking style. You gotta up your game when you go in estate sale and at a very big piles, so you gotta be quick and you gotta think things through very fast. So all right, I'll try and get some footage of it. I could get the GoPro going. I could just bring the GoPro,
I'm going to be there tonight, late night, so I can bring the GoPro, charge it up, get it all going, and run in there with the body camera.
Might be pretty cool. I think we'll bring it just in case and try it out. Be nerved about it, but I don't want the camera to slow me down in any way, but all right. Till the next one. Peace. Zee-dee-dee-dee-dee.